Hello students, welcome to My Abhyas. Here we are with the second chapter of first year, that is 11th standard. And we started with this class with biological classification. We had one more set of videos where we have discussed the initial part, that is introduction part, and about Kingdom Monera. I hope you have gone through those videos and understood the complete concept. Let us quickly revise though one more time. We are talking about the second chapter of our first year portions, that is biological classification. As per your board exams point of view, you have only 2 marks which may come from this chapter. And for your competitive exams point of view, this may be for two to three questions from this, and that may carry maybe 4 to 8 marks. That's okay for us, because we are not going to leave any marks behind and we are going to get all the marks out of out. So don't worry for this. We are going to talk about biological classification in detail in this part as well. So we are talking about chapter number 2, biological classification. Now we started with the Kingdom Monera in the previous session, and in the previous session I have also told you about how does this 5-kingdom classification has been done. It started with 2-kingdom classification, then it has gone to 3, 4, and at the end it was 5-kingdom classification, which was given by R. H. Whittaker. R. H. Whittaker was the scientist who decided, who checked all the characteristics depending on the cell size, phylogenetic characteristics, the evolutionary characteristics, and what he found out that the kingdoms can be classified into 5 ways, that is Monera, Protista, Fungus, Plantia, and Animalia. We have done with the Monera, that is the prokaryotic organisms which have a simple body organization, and they are the basically bacteria. We have studied about Archaebacteria, new bacteria in the previous session. In this session, we are going to start with Protista. Okay, let me once write it down all the 5 kingdom one more time, so that quickly that will be recalled by in your mind. The first kingdom, which includes the prokaryotic organisms, are Monera. The second kingdom, that is what we are going to talk today, is Protista. Then comes the funguses, that is fungi. And then we have another 2 more, that is advanced animals and the plants, that is plant or plantia and animalia. And the animalia. Okay. So we have this 5-kingdom classification. Animalia and Plantia are the higher category of organisms. They have most well-developed body structure and body organization. What is remaining? Monera, Protista, and fungi for us. Those are the simpler form of organisms. And on that note, we have already studied about Monera. Let us start with Protista. What are Protistas and how can we know about these Protistas in detail? Let us see about Kingdom Protista in this slide. Protistas are the most biologically diverse kingdom. Biologically diverse means what? This term means they have different varieties of organisms present in this kingdom. They are different in their cell form. They are different from each other in their nutrition pattern, reproduction pattern, locomotion pattern, and so on. So we see a wide range of characteristics in these group of organisms, that is Protista. Okay, and till now, approximately 50,000 living species has been discovered by this kingdom Protista. Okay, so 50,000 Protistas has already been discovered by this by the scientists from this kingdom Protista. Okay, this kingdom includes all the assortment of living things, as I told you, all the different varieties of living things, which may vary in their body form, lifestyle, nutrition, locomotion, and reproduction. What are they going to do? What are we going to see? We can see different type of body forms for them. We can check their lifestyle, that why, how they stay, and what is the environment they prefer to be alive. Then we have seen actually different varieties. We'll be seeing about different nutrition characteristics of these Protistas. We will also be seeing the different type of locomotion, that is movement. How do they move around? About the movement of the particular Protista organisms. And we will also see the different varieties of reproduction. That is wide a range of characteristics which is present in all these Protistas. So what are protistas? Protistas are the eukaryotic organisms, and these protistas are actually a link between the monera and the fungi. See, what we studied in monera, monera were the prokaryotes, right? They were having a very simple body organization. They did not had any proper nucleus, they don't have proper cell organelle and so on. But when we talk about kingdom protista, we see that they started developing proper nucleus, proper cell organelle, and all the things are arranged properly. So that is about kingdom protista. So protista is the most biologically diverse kingdom, which has approximately 50,000 different species. And this kingdom includes different varieties of living things, which they are different in their lifestyle, in the mode of nutrition, in the locomotion, and in reproduction. Is it clear to you? Now, in kingdom protista, if we check in kingdom protista, we can say that these kingdoms are like a connecting link. Protista is somewhere in between. Their characteristics are somewhere in between than that of monera, which are the simpler form, and the next one is funguses. So when I talk about funguses, monera to protista to fungus, these protistas are staying in between and connecting a link between the moneras and between the funguses. Okay, so they are the prokaryotic kingdoms are the monera, whereas when I talk about protista, they are multicellular kingdoms. And they are actually the link between the multicellular funguses, plants, and animals. And on the other hand, there is a monera. So this protista is somewhere staying in between. Did you get it? One side we have the simpler form of organism, and the other side we have all the complex forms of organisms. These protistas are staying in between and making a link, or they are like a connecting link between the previous one and the next category of or next kingdom. Hence, they are regarded as ancestors of all multicellular eukaryotic organisms. These organisms are the ancestors of all the multicellular eukaryotic organisms. These are the organisms which are, they are connecting link. That means during the primitive earth formation, when the earth was getting created, it was believed that the monera are the first kingdom to be evolved, where they did not have a proper cell structure, they didn't have a proper nucleus, no proper cell organelle. So that was the first type of organisms which has evolved on the earth. From monera, it gone to protista. These protistas are unicellular, but they also show some colonial formation, and they are eukaryotic. So can't I say that after monera, immediately I see the characteristics in protistas, and these protistas are actually later stages has evolved to form funguses, plants, and animals. Got it, right? So this, if I talk phylogenetically, if we think that how the organisms has evolved, on that note, we can tell that they are actually the connecting link between the prokaryotic organisms and the multicellular complex organisms. Hence, they are regarded as ancestors of all the multicellular eukaryotic organisms. All the multicellular eukaryotic organisms are basically has come from this kingdom protista. Let us talk about their general characteristics. Now, how you are going to go about this particular chapter? Whenever we are learning a particular chapter, we will be first discussing about their general characteristics. Then we will be classifying that particular kingdom into different groups, and we will be studying about all the characteristics of those groups. I am going to tell you each and every point in depth, including your competitive exam portions also, so that you don't feel any difficulty. For maybe the things are easy, or if what could be the maximum or toughest part which may come in your exam. Everything will be discussed in these video sessions. Okay, so let us first talk about the general characteristics of kingdom protista. Protistas are basically unicellular. Unicellular means they are having only one cell. Okay, so they are made up of basically one cell. Now, how does this cell exist? A single cell can exist just like that, like individually. They are not attached with any other organism. So that is a possibility that these cells may be present individually without any organisms connected to it. These cells also will be present in the form of colonies, we call them as colonial. Colonial means they will be combining together to form the colonies. So the cells can be unicellular, solitary or colonial microorganism. They can present individually or they can present in a combination or in a group of other organisms also. Clear? They are eukaryotes with well-defined nuclear envelope and cell organelles. These organisms, these eukaryotic cells, they have a well-defined nucleus and they have proper cell organelles. Okay. So whatever you check about a prokaryote, eukaryotic organism supposed to be, they should be developed one. Similar characteristics is seen in this protista also. Okay, so these protistas are basically having a well-defined nuclear envelope and they are having a proper cell organelle present on their body. Okay, then how do they live? What is the condition? They live in the aquatic forms. Aquatic means in the water. So they occur as free living aquatic organism. Freely in the water bodies we found them. These are floating organisms and we call them as plankton. What we call them as? We call them as plankton. So these are floating organisms and they are called as plankton. Okay. Plankton. Plankton means they are present in a simple, they are floating on the earth, on the water surface, floating over there. Okay. So that is why they are very important, because they are the food for other bigger organisms also, like, you know, the fishes, the other water animals. They will be engulfing them and eating them. I'll talk about it a little later. But first of all, you understand that they are either free living aquatic forms or they will be freely floating and they are called as planktons. Okay. Now, when I talk about the general characteristics, how do they have their nutrition? When we talk about the nutrition can be of two types, autotrophic mode of nutrition or heterotrophic mode of nutrition. When we say the autotrophic mode of nutrition, that means they are autotrophs. What is the meaning of autotrophs? These organisms have their pigment present on them and they can photosynthesize their food. They can make their of their own food. They can prepare or synthesize their own food. Okay. So autotrophic forms are photosynthetic. They are preparing their own food in nature. The heterotrophic forms either saprophytic or parasitic. So if they are autotrophs, what is the meaning of autotrophs? Autotrophs means in the presence of sunlight and by absorbing the carbon dioxide from the nature, by taking water from the atmosphere and by taking the minerals, they can synthesize their own food in the simplest form, like in the form of glucose. These are called as autotrophs. So these particular category, those who are autotrophs, they have a capacity to prepare their own food. They can synthesize their own food. If they're heterotrophic, what will happen? If they're heterotrophic, in that case, either they're saprophytic or parasitic. Now, what is the meaning of saprophyte and parasite? Saprophytes are those organisms which are dependent on dead and decaying matter to take their food. What are parasites? Parasites are those organisms which stays with another organism and can cause harm to the organism. Got it, right? So, either they are saprophytic or parasitic in the heterotrophic form. And in the autotrophic form, they are photosynthetic in nature. Okay. Then, how do they move around? The locomotion is by pseudopodia, flagella or cilia. How do they move around? They move around by either having a pseudopodia, that is false leg, or they may have flagella or cilia. I hope you can see the presence of flagella and cilia over here. This is the cilia and this is the flagella. How are they moving? They have pseudopodia. What does a pseudopodia mean? Pseudopodia is seen in case of amoeba. Pseudopodia means false foot. Okay. False foot means pseudopodia. So what happens? Amoeba generally develops a particular part of its body towards the foot. And these parts, you know, helps in the locomotion too. So this will be helping to pull the organism towards one particular area. Okay. So generally what happens? Amoeba type of organisms are showing a presence of pseudopodia. That means they have a false leg present over there. Whereas some of the organisms will be showing cilia and some of them will be showing flagella.